Welcome back to the broadcast of Altibox Norway Chess. We are being joined by the world champion himself and the leader of the tournament. Magnus, congratulations on your performance so far. Can you tell us about your today's game against Ricardo?
Yeah, it wasn't very exciting. So when he played this particular line, I thought perhaps his intention was to play e4 and to go for this line of position. Although it's not considered to be promising, I thought maybe in terms of style, that's what he would want.
He said the exact opposite, that today he didn't feel like playing the isolated.
Yeah, no. I mean, I realized when he took on with the knight that he probably wasn't so ambitious today. And then I think I'm not sure, too sure about the way I played here, but I feel.
Was it at this point that you went to the confessional after move 16?
Yeah, no. I mean, I kind of thought I was a little bit worrisome because I thought he was gonna go rook c1, and in case I go rook with the bishop to c8, then he would take. And I'm not sure, quite sure I have enough compensation because queen e6 would threaten the rook.
Is this the position you were slightly afraid of?
No, I was just gonna play with the rook.
Right.
And then very knight e4. That should be quite alright, and also after knight c6, we can take.
Mm-hmm.
This should be pretty solid. I mean, I was worried I might be a little worse, but probably I'm not. And yeah, after queen, knight f5, everything comes on. It's nothing more to take.
So you thought that knight f5 was basically like a draw? So.
Yeah, sure. But yeah, I mean, he could have played something else, but I guess he wasn't too inclined to try to hurt him.
What do you think about the rest of the positions? You have been looking at the other games, and they seem to be really exciting today.
Yeah, it's very interesting. So, I thought watching the game, I thought f4 was a really typical Maxim move. Like I saw the position before, and I was sure it's going to go f4 because that's how he likes to play.
Do you think there's still a chance that he has had this analyzed? Because he had the really long things before, so he used a lot of time. Do you think that he was trying to recall something? Is there a chance that this is still something that he had seen, even if it was much long ago?
Yeah. No, I don't think so.
Just making it up?
Yeah, I would guess so. I mean, by now for sure. I think perhaps this position, he after knight c4, he must have had at some point. But the thing is that this line is nobody plays bishop c4 and knight d2 anymore.
This line,
yeah,
it's
very interesting. But there must be something new. I think. I mean, this line with b6 is basically the reason why people stop playing with white, because it's white was not getting anywhere. But all the topical games there are from I think at least 5 years ago. So probably Maxim didn't check his notes in a long time. And then Sergei certainly had a very concrete preparation. Maybe Sergei has had this position on the board. It just wasn't one of the main lines, so I couldn't recall it. But yeah, it looks, I don't know, like FG at this point. Rook goes and bishop, I don't know, bishop g6, rook b7. It's very hard to say.
Yeah, that's exactly what Ricardo was pointing at.
So maybe he has to go bishop f3. Then should be better for white.
You think white is better, but
yeah,
it's not an easy position to play.
It's clearly not easy. And then I would, in Shaq's shoes, I would be pretty happy, I think. I mean, first of all, bishop b4 looks quite reasonable. It looks like it should be making a draw. heard of all this, so I'm fine and for it, but it doesn't look super messy. I'd just say three. I would be happy with it, but I can't. This is also the other line that's been considered solved basically for Black for 10 years.
Why do you think Lavin went for this?
I mean, like, what? Maybe it's just hoping he had some small idea, or he's just hoping that Jack didn't remember. And also, probably he was more thinking about the lines with B6 and maybe also Princess 7 rather than this. And because people kind of stopped doing this with Black because there were some lines with Queen D2 and then Bishop G5 or Bishop H6, and then it was usually a draw with kind of the English Queen for Black. But it's typical of the one that he thinks it's new when it's long for the
Feels like new.
Yeah.
And the remaining game between Anand and Song, what do you think about their position?
Yeah, it looks pretty bad. So I assume he's gonna trade, and then, but whatever, I mean, trade F4, EF4,
What do you think was Vichy's approach for today's game, going for the English instead of
Vichy? Usually White gets a little bit better in this line, but like he's able to gradually progress. And maybe with some mini improvement, he could still have posed some problems, but not anymore. I think it's just that.
Thank you for your evaluation of the games. The final question of mine should, of course, be about the free day and how did you enjoy the experience of cooking together with your teammate Wesley So?
Well, it has to be said that Wesley was pretty good, which was fortunate for our team. And at the start, I was really motivated because I thought there's no way I would be able to do any of this anyway, so it was just going to take a lot of time. But eventually, Wesley did some things right, and I also got into it, and we managed to make an edible meal, which was a nice surprise.
We saw your second, Peter Hena, and your father enjoying the meal because they had a chance to taste it. Do you think that this will actually give you some will of cooking in the future just for fun, or you thought that it was a once in a lifetime enough?
No, I mean, I've cooked before, just not fish.
Alright, so you do cook?
No, not much, but a little. But I wouldn't read too much into what they're saying, because they eat a lot and they eat absolutely everything. So. But still, it was a nice experience after all, and I always kind of like cooking. I just didn't do it very much. So maybe I'll start to do it.
Oh, that's great to hear. It's a new side of yours that we have to know. Thank you for joining us, Magnus, and good luck for the rest of the event.